Hey cinema fans, welcome back to a rewatch review of the Spider-Man 90s animated series. Try saying that three times. Now for a lot of you, the 90s Spider-Man animated series and the X-Men animated series was your introduction to Marvel and the world of Marvel, from Hulk to the Fantastic Four to Iron Man, Daredevil, the Punisher, and all these great villains, Magneto to the Green Goblin, Venom, Carnage, all of them, Doctor Strange. We start the season off and the whole series off with a great, marvelous episode, The Night of the Lizard, about Dr. Connors, the lizard basically. But we really start off the episode with Spider-Man overlooking New York City and the whole city, and this long monologue he has in his mind that he has throughout the series, which is very close to the comics and respectful to the comics. And this whole season and series takes a lot of stories from the comics and brings it into its own little spin. And a little, it's simplified, yes, but it has its own little spin to sometimes it kind of question, is this even a kid's cartoon or is this like a... Now, it doesn't go to the level of the Batman animated series and how mature it is, but it does go there a little bit sometimes throughout the series. But for season one, it's really focused on more of the individual episodes. Yes, there is a through storyline that goes along, but unlike the other seasons where it focuses more on the main storyline, that through line, but this one, this main season, really focuses on really the individual episodes and each episode feeling like its own little short film. Season one, if you look at it, is more setting down the groundwork, which will be built upon in later seasons, because there's five seasons. So season two, the five, is built upon by the groundwork that was played out and built upon on season one. Spider-Man runs into villains like Mysterio, Kraven the Hunter, Venom, Kingpin, Hobgoblin. We are introduced to other villains like Norman Osborn, but he doesn't become Green Goblin until later on in the series. But the main villain, and also Spider-Slayer as well, but the main villain is really, I would say, Kingpin, Wilson Fisk, because you see how he's connected to all these villains, how he sets them up, like from Norman Osborn that leads into the Hobgoblin, Jameson. Kingpin also plays a part into the whole alien costume three-parter, little three-episode run. And it shows how interconnected and how much of a Kingpin he is and how he's such a threat to Spider-Man. And the alien costume three-part episode run was so good that they actually took that and turned it into like a TV movie and released it to DVD, even to this day. You probably can find it. I actually own it myself. But it's so good. I mean, that three-parter was so inspirational. Even Sam Raimi used it on Spider-Man 3. Not even the alien costume episodes, also the Doc Ock episodes were such inspiration to Sam Raimi that he plucked from those episodes, making Doc Ock more of a sympathetic villain and very how he comes about being a villain. Because in the comics, he's more of this, you know, I'm a villain bad guy. But in the series, they kind of lay him out to be more of a sympathetic science teacher that would teach Peter Parker and that whole connection, kind of like you see in the Spider-Man PS4 game. And that's what I love about all these animated series. They even did it with the Batman animated series when they worked on the Mr. Freeze, because Mr. Freeze was way different in the comics than he was in the series that people used and ran with later on down the road in the comics, movies, and games. And like I said, season one was just laying out the groundwork to be built upon in later seasons, and the way they do it and how they interconnect it and how the story is told throughout the series and the seasons is just, it's a masterpiece. Me personally, I think. And for a kid's cartoon animated series, it baffles me, but in a good way. So with all that to be said, I want to give this an 8.5 out of 10 for the 90s Spider-Man animated series. And if you want to check out the series, it's all available to be streamed on Disney+, so go please check it out. Thank you for watching and follow for more.